This is a short video explaining the controls on the top of the interface here. The first one is purge, which means you can purge a phrase from RAM and it won't play. If you try to play it, it will pop up this message telling you that it is purged, and you can click this button. You can also command click it, and then it's sort of a solo function where you will only have this phrase loaded and the rest of the phrases unloaded. You can also see it in the key coloring here. They are now all yellow, which means these are all purged. Or you can shift click it to just unpurge all of the phrases and have them all back in memory. The next control is the mod wheel icon, which determines whether the volume for this phrase is controlled by the mod wheel. If I turn this off for this phrase, for instance, and I play first phrase and this one at the same time, you can hear that the strings phrase will be softer. The synth phrase will stay at the same level. The next button here is our tempo control for this phrase, where ITM means intelligent tempo mapping. The other options are just normal phrase speed, double phrase speed, and half phrase speed. When set to intelligent tempo mapping, the tempo will double or half for this phrase automatically when a certain threshold of stretch is reached. The library is recorded in 135 BPM, and you can see the current stretch percentage of the phrase on the top left. The harmonic shift function was originally intended to allow for expanded chords where the phrase would only have a triad material usually, and then you could, for instance, layer an E minor chord on top of a C major chord and that way create your C major seventh chord without having to have these tensions in the phrase itself, which would be a bit restrictive sometimes. It has quite a few uses though. One of the ones I like most is to use it as a quick chord switcher, where it will pick chords that have the right quality relative to your bass chord. The way it works in its most basic form is this. I play a phrase, in this case in C minor, and then I switch to the relative minor third higher and a tritone higher. So if I do the same thing with D minor as a bass chord, it will still switch to the relative minor third and the relative tritone. The main thing to note for the purpose of this video is that you can turn it on or off with this button here, and that you can do stuff like load the same phrase in two slots and then have one harmonic shifted and the other staying in the same place, and create harmonies that way. Finally, you can view the score for the currently playing phrase in various keys as well. And you can set the relative level for the added synth. And if there is another phrase in a different section that is composed to work well together with this phrase, you can add it by using the plus button. And the plus button will be in the color or colors of the sections that you can add. That completes this explanation of the buttons in the upper bit of the block. For these buttons, please watch the tweaking video. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it and the instrument itself will prove useful to you. Please check out the other videos on the website. If you have any problems using the instrument, please do let us know at support.sonokinetic.net.